It was looking at me.
Who was?
The camera was looking at me. YouTube was looking at me.
Oh, jeez. Are we all set now?
We are. We're live.
All right. Excellent. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. We're on an 18 by 24 inch canvas. It's Paint with Josh on a SantaDay Saturday live show, oil painting show, right? Woo! Just came running up the stairs. I'm always late. I'm never here and ready. So, we got Dark Sienna, Bright Red, Cadmium Yellow, Phthalo Green, Phthalo Blue, Alizarin Crimson, Midnight Black, Titanium White. We actually need to get a little bit more Midnight Black. So while I'm doing that, tell me where you're watching from, what time it is where you are. Everybody check in. What time it is, where you're watching from, and what's your favorite sandwich? We always love to know the sandwich question. So everybody, always comment, like, tap the screen if you're watching on Facebook and TikTok. Make sure you like it if you're watching on YouTube. While I get the last of these colors out. All right. Now, added a little bit more crimson, a little bit more blue. Now we're gonna do a cool little Aurora Borealis scene today with a lot of Phthalo Green. So I'm gonna load up the brush with the Phthalo Green just like that. We're gonna come around here, and wherever we want that green to kind of shine through is where we need to put it, right? I don't wanna cover the entire canvas in Phthalo Green, but we wanna spread it out. Keep it nice and dark. And the more you spread it, the darker it's going to become. It's going to get thinner and thinner on that black. There we go. Very cool. All right, I want to have a little bit different color, maybe some blue up in the sky as well. But we'll take some more of that Phthalo Green. Again, if you drop it real heavy on your canvas, it's going to be very bright. So you're going to want to spread it. Spread it out. You don't need all that thick bit in one area, right? Gorgeous bit of Phthalo Green. I love this color. It's fantastic. So initially we put Bob Ross Liquid Clear on our canvas, which is looks just like that. That's what's allowing us to blend all these colors. If you took a dry canvas and stuck this brush up against it, you would not be very happy. Bob Ross used to say you would be in Agony City. Because it is no good. You have to have a wet canvas and put wet paint on it. That's the wet on wet, right? All right, we're going to take a little bit of our blue. Switch colors, go to our blue. Look at that. Ooh, it's fantastic. Look at all those gorgeous colors in the brush. All right, drop a little bit of our blue maybe on this side. And then we'll just let them blend in, and then we'll start to paint with white paint, and just like magic, all the white color and all these blue and greens are gonna mix and show through. It's gonna be great. So, taking that blue, mixing it in with the green on the top, on the bottom. Remember, how many people we got watching, babe? Where are they from?
650 on TikTok.
Hey, guys.
Give me 1 second. I'm getting set up on everything else.
No worries. We're going to take a little bit more of that blue, and we're going to come down into the bottom left corner of the canvas and reflect. So we have green and green and blue and blue. Kind of like a checkerboard.
Phthalo blue.
The Phthalos. Maybe we'll call this like Phthalo Cove or something just to do with the colors. There we go. Now we got a little green, we got a little blue everywhere. Maybe take a little bit of the blue up in the corners just so there's not black canvas, right? We don't want dry black canvas or uncovered black canvas anyway. Because as soon as we go across it with our white, the white is going to be, it's going to have nothing to mix with. You got to have these undercolors there. Josh's undercolors. That's the technique. And then when we go over it with our white paint, it really starts to shine. So let's do this. We're gonna wash off the brush. I'll show you guys real quick how we do it. Right into the cup, right? You dip it in. My cup is only about down to here. It's not the full cup, right? And that way I have a little bit of room where I can take all of this stuff and twist it off so it remains inside the cup. And we twist it like that, shake it off.
Shake it off.
Shake it off. Now we'll go into a trash can, shake off the rest, and then into the old beater bucket. And we're going to beat the devil out of it, just like that. Try to show everybody. I've got an old golf ball basket down in the bottom, and that's what I had in my garage when I very first started.
It's
and that's
really
what we use now.
Bright in here.
That's what we use now. All right. It's these ones. Okay, here we go. Let's do some painting. Who's ready to paint?
Everybody's ready to paint.
Let's take an old fan brush, right? I love this guy because he's got like a little thing that hangs out on the end.
Hey, babe, Fuzz is here.
Hey, Fuzz, doing a flex. Ah, Fuzz. All right, here we go. So we're going to grab up our white paint just like this. We have our blue and blue, green and green. And then when we go across it, it's going to make these gorgeous, gorgeous colors. Right? We don't need a whole lot. It's actually probably too much. I'm going to save that. We'll save that for later. I get started talking to you guys, and then I forget what the heck we're doing up here, right? So we don't need a whole lot. Couple swipes on either side. You can tell the difference. The one on the left, way too much paint. See that? See how there's way too much on there? Looks like it's the same, but there's very little amount of paint on this guy. Right, so I don't want to use the one that's too much. That'll cause us problems. Now, let's say we had this cool, like, Aurora Borealis reflection, which is going to be really neat, and we can do a lot of them, but I want to have, like, the big one. Actually, maybe we'll start over here. And right as we go with our white paint, just like that, we come up to the canvas, just kind of slide over. Bam, just leave this whole little thing, just like that. We're going to come up, take our 2-inch brush. Bam, bam. I love doing this on the TikToks, like, rotating it, and then when it does that boomerang effect, it just sits and rotates all day. Okay, now we're going to take the 2-inch brush and with a little bit of pressure, grab this guy and just pull up. And the more pressure and the more paint that you drag up, the cooler little effect you'll get. All right, you want them to be really long. Pull it up, but pull it up straight. Very little amount on the bottom just to soften it, right? And all of a sudden, you got very cool little Aurora Borealis reflections.
That's
very neat. Hey, Dad, thanks for tuning in. Very softly to the side. Get these cool little things to happen. All right, now with the other color, look, the other side of the brush is still white. So we can do like a whole nother one. Maybe it came in, I don't know, maybe it came in like this. And then we could do its reflection down around the bottom as well. Just like that, right? Make a whole giant mess. That's all it is.
What are you doing?
One big mess. I'm going to show you. Ready? We're going to go like this. I'm going to take it. Start to pull up. Pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up.
Pull up, terrain. Pull up, terrain.
Pull a little bit down, right? But we're going to get a little bit more over here, too. Let's see, maybe it came down a little bit thicker of a line, right? You can always add paint, so start with a little
and
then add it.
Croatia is watching.
Hey, somebody from Croatia. That's wicked, right? And we're not going to use all of this, a little bit straight down.
Hey
don't
guys,
need to use the whole thing.
If you're new here, Josh does do tutorials, free videos released every week on a Tuesday through the month of December. Whether or not we'll go back to Wednesdays, I don't know.
Yeah,
December's
right.
Working out pretty well. So if you are interested in watching a full tutorial, after the lives are over, they will be posted to December's live section over on YouTube. He does also have a subscription-based model on TikTok, on Facebook, and on YouTube if you are interested in interacting and asking questions.
Yeah, we love responding back to people in real time. All right, let's take another one in here. Get all sorts of differences in color as they start to blend out, blend together. Maybe this guy was like just a branch off of the other one.
Branch, my man.
Branch. You get all these cool little ribbons that come down when you do these things. Very neat. Very neat. Cool little things start to happen. All right, maybe we'll throw one more back in here. Just a little guy. It doesn't need to be a whole lot. And they don't all have to be on the same level either. Right? Take the guy, pull him up from the bottom to the top. Right? Pull it up. You could do this all day, but don't lose all these dark colors in between. Right?
Wah, 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 wah. You just hit 50,000.
Hey, 50,000 followers. Holy crap, you guys. Maybe do one more over here. Watch, it's got a little bit of color on the brush, but we'll come down. And maybe underneath. Just a little line. That's all you need. See how the difference, though? Blue, green, differences in our sky. Maybe we'll connect this guy all the way across. Doesn't have to be a straight line. Remember that. The ribbons never come down in a straight line. I don't want to pull so much that I bring it up and touch this guy either. So I'm going to come down like that.
Puerto Rico's in the house.
Hey, Puerto Rico, that's wicked.
We got Pittsburgh, we got Minnesota, we got Oregon, we got Missouri.
Missouri in the house. That might be a little bit too much paint.
Romania.
Hey, wicked. Checking out all over the world. Paint
Nebraska,
with Josh.
Connecticut, North Carolina, Boston, Massachusetts.
That's cool, man. That is cool. Just like that. Make all these cool little changes, cool little differences, different little things start to happen very lightly. And we're like, oh, what happened to the bottom? Right? Take a little bit down here. Maybe there was that one that was up in there. We might lose a lot of the bottom because we're going to do a lot of foreground. You know what I mean? But just in case, we'll pull this guy down.
I feel like I should sing that song.
What song?
The state song.
Oh, about all the different places that are watching?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Czech Republic in the house.
Hey, Czech Republic. That's wicked.
Rhode Island.
Island.
Rhode Island. There we go. Now, all this stuff down underneath is going to be water, so it can be all wavy and crazy and different.
Question.
And you know how it's got that? Yes.
Did you paint black gesso on the canvas to start, and does it have to dry fully?
Well, yes. If you cover your white canvas in black gesso, yes, it has to dry all the way before you start with your oils. Secondly, I bought this canvas black already. I didn't have to prep it. All I did was put my liquid clear on, and we started to paint. Now, let's wash a few brushes. Only take me about 10 seconds, so don't go anywhere. I'm going to wash these brushes off. We'll get back to painting. Yeah, somebody time me. Time me 10 seconds.
Time you? Well, you've been live right now for 11 minutes. So.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a little bit longer. All right, let's wash this big 2-inch brush off as well. And again, one more time, I'm going to show you into the cup. Right? Again, the level's only about halfway down, so I can pull it up and spin it and get all that excess liquid to come off. We're going to shake it into a can. And then into the beater bucket. Gonna beat the devil out of it. All right, nice and clean. Look at that. It's gorgeous. Comes out gorgeous. Ooh. People seem to like when I made that noise. All right, now we're gonna mix up a little bit of our darker color because I want to throw this wicked mountain range in, which is gonna cover up any part of your sky that you don't like. So let's grab up the red and the black and the blue. Mix them all up into this deep dark color down here, and it'll be like almost like a very dark purpley color, right? Take a small little bit of white so you can see what we're working with. It's a very very dark purple. And depending on how much color you have, if you have more crimson, it's gonna be much more purple. If you have more blue, it'll be more blue. So depending on what color you want, you gotta mix it up, right? So we'll take a little bit of blue. I never make enough paint. This is why I did this just twice. Because I looked at my paint pile and said, oh, that's not gonna be enough. Not gonna be enough. Okay, let's wipe this off, get my big head out of the way. And then we're going to come in and we'll load up our bigger knife with just a whole bunch of color, right? We're going to take it like this, spread it out, pull it out flat, scoop it up. You want to have that's a good eighth of an inch worth of paint. Look at that. It's just like a giant amount of paint. Ooh, right? We're going to come back in. I'm going to come up and just start to decide where the tip tops of our mountains live. Boom, maybe my guy lives right over here. And it might be a little hard to see until I start to light it up. So give me a second. Trust the process, right? Throw that nasty, purpley, dark mixture all along the edge. We're only worried about what the top edge looks like. So if you have any parts that are kind of open, pull it off like that. Are we nice and zoomed in for everybody? I didn't even check.
Oh, you've got to pull up.
I didn't even check. Yeah, we're good. We're good on everything.
Yeah.
Okay, what's the poll?
The poll is, do you feel inspired?
Do you feel inspired? There we go.
95% of the people say yes, 5% say very inspired.
Excellent. Okay, we're going to take our 1-inch brush, nice, clean, dry 1-inch brush. We're going to come up here, start to pull this guy out, and maybe he'll start to just show himself a little bit to us since it's very dark. All right, get this soft little thing happening down here. Now, I'm not going to reflect the mountain down into the water down here. All this color is just our water. We're going to have these nice, soft reflections into it. And depending on how we pull the brush, and take it, and slide it out, pull this guy off to the side, pulling him down. Maybe there's this big ridge that hides over here. Who knows? We're going to figure it out. All right, pulling it down here. There we go. Now we're going to put a little bit of white on there just to show you what it looks like. So I'm going to take a little bit of here, and then we're going to give ourselves just a guide. It's not even a whole lot of paint. Look at that. Oh, it's just big. And it's not even just on the one side. What's up? Oh.
Nothing.
So maybe over here, we're just going to throw little things on the ridges that I want to show you that are going to be lit, right?
I just wanted to get closer to you.
Hi, baby.
Hey, babe. What kind of brushes are those?
So these are GAC Doctor fan
GAC
brushes.
GAC Doctor.
Yeah, GACDR. If anybody can see that, GAC Doctor. They're really nice hog hair brushes, and you get like 5 of them for $10. They're awesome. I swear by them. Okay, watch. We're going to take this little bit of light area, and now you start to see the lighter sides of my mountain back there, right? And then we'll really go back in and highlight them. But at least you can see the ridge. It's like a dragon's back. Dragon Ridge, we'll call this one.
Hey, babe, where do you get your liquid clear from?
So I get it from Amazon, and I have an Amazon affiliate shop where I sell, or I have listed, all of those things. And if you buy them from me, I get a couple pennies. So my Amazon shop is amazon.com/shop/paintwithjosh. And if you go over there, it's got all the stuff I use, from the tools to the palette to the easel to the canvases to everything. And then, you know, stuff I wish I had. Let's see, a little bit of blue in here. Gonna mix that up, so we're gonna have some kind of blue soft shadows. Maybe take a little bit of the phthalo green, put that in here too. Everybody mix up, it's like a very sea green color. And then take a small little bit of black, or, you know, our dark mixture over here. I call it black because it looks black.
Mark.
And we're gonna mix that up. That's gonna be our shadow color.
Mark Anderson coming in with the 300 stars.
Oh, thanks, Mark, for sending the stars over on Facebook.
So
look at that. Whoever sends the most gifts gets the best view. So Facebook gets the best view, I guess. Now we're gonna take a little bit right on the edge of our knife, just like that. This gorgeous little color. Woo! Look at this. Oh my goodness. And just very lightly start to play and drop in little shadows. What's happening back on the edge of our mountains back here? What's going on? Well, we're never going to see everything, right? So you don't have to light everything up. But maybe on the back side of here, we had one just come in just so softly. Maybe it starts to make a little valley down here. Get this cool little thing start happening, right? And pull it off this way. You get this another little ridge. And you start to build mountains. You can literally move mountains, guys. Very simply and easily done. And again, we're only doing the shadows, so leave some space. Leave some space for our bright highlights to come in and stick between the peaks, right? You're gonna have light, dark, light. Well, it's, I mean, it's very light color, but it will be darker than the light. So light, dark, all the way around, right? So leave room, don't cover too much. Maybe on this guy, we had a whole little, get a whole little thing. Look at that, that snow just breaks so softly. Wow, it's so gentle.
Hey, whatever platform you guys are watching on, if you could hit that share button, we do greatly appreciate it. Whether or not you share it to your Facebook feed, share it to your friends on TikTok, or whether or not you share copy link from YouTube and send it to your grandma, we do really appreciate pushing the life out.
Yeah, guys, it really helps. Thank you. Go ahead, babe.
Oh, I don't. I was coughing.
Oh, yeah. We really appreciate the help. We do this for free, and we, you know, we appreciate the support. We know not everyone's going to support, but maybe a few people will. And you can go to our Etsy shop right down here, paintwithjosh.etsy.com. I sell all of these paintings. I have shirts that I'm wearing. I have hats. This UFO hat, UFO Mountains hat for everybody. Everybody see?
Wah, wah, wah,
wah. Wah, wah, wah. All right, we're going to take our, not white, right, because I mixed it in with that shadowy color, and that way it won't be pure white. So we're going to take our not white color, very, very, very bright blue color, like a very sky blue. Scrape that up, and it's going to look white as we come up here. So maybe we're going to come up. Grab, start to throw it down. Very soft pressure, right? All depends on what you want it to look like. Over here, I'm going to cover it with a tree, so it really doesn't matter. Sorry. Oh my
Joshua.
Lord. I'm sorry. It was built up.
That was awful.
Going to come down into this side of our and let it blend in with that little bit of our valley down there, right? And you go from shadowy to light, but leaving a lot of that dark area. Leave the darkness. There were so many funny little stitches and stuff on that video that we had done, that big, you know, 1.9 million views now, you guys. My God.
Looks like ass.
Yeah, the guy was like, he was watching me do the clouds, and he goes, I saw him do this scribble thing, and I was like, that's going to look like straight ass. And then he did this thing, and it was done, and I was like, yes! It was so, like, I got that guy. He thought it was going to be horrible, and it turned out being fantastic, and he loved it. And it inspired him to start doing more art. He's like, he said he always got like a kind of artist block when it came to doing his own deal. Just like that. Very cool. Little differences though, right? Light, dark. Even though they're very close, you get that little bit of shadow back there. And this is Ryan Reynolds doing a mountain. Yeah. Everyone said I sounded like Ryan Reynolds and Bob Ross and Heath Ledger. And somebody said Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah, we've got Bill Hader.
Bill Hader was, yeah, that was a lot too. Somebody said that a lot. Your brain wants you to go all this down here, right? Maybe we leave that section dark. It's very shadowy over there. What's happening? If you can't see it, your brain will make it up. So just jiggle that. Maybe we got that whole little ridge back there that's just hidden in this real deep, dark shadow.
If you see our life goal at the top, it's for air dancers. If you send an air dancer, Joshua will make
it
myself and dance for a couple of seconds.
Should I give him a freebie?
You should give him a freebie.
I'll do the thing from Family Guy. Wacky Waving Inflatable Arm Flailing Tube Man! Wacky Waving Inflatable Arm Flailing Tube Man! I'm Al Harrington, owner of Wacky Waving Inflatable Arm Flailing Tube Man and Emporium and Warehouse, and we're here to pass these painting tips along to you! Yeah, so.
It gets funnier every time you do it.
We like to have fun. Let's use the rest of this light color over here. And all depends on our swipes and what we leave and what we don't leave. All these little dark areas, right? Get all these cool little things start happening. Very neat. And you don't even have to cover everything, right? Who says you have to see everything? You don't. You never have to see it all. But look at all that black that we left in there. All those little dark areas. Fantastic. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Leaving little differences, little things. So, yeah. All right, now we're going to take the bottom of that guy. Actually needs a little, we're going to scrape up the last little bit. Maybe over here we got to bring it down to our water. And again, I'm choosing not to reflect the mountain into the water because we're going to have some foreground over it. So we're really only going to see maybe the tip of this guy right here. We're going to have some bushes in the front, maybe a couple big trees. Be kind of cool. So we're going to take our dry 2-inch brush. It's a lot like that. And we're going to come in, start to swipe from the sides and go up, not to touch the peak. I don't want to touch the peak, right? You don't want to come up here where it's very thick. You want to stay down here where you ran out of paint on the knife and it broke very thin like that. Don't want to use too much, right? On this side, we're going to go up this way because we came down this way. So now we have to go up the opposite way very, very lightly, so lightly, like just the teeniest, tiniest bit. Turn the brush, come back up this way. Right? Again, trying not to lose all those dark areas. The more you go over it, the more you're gonna kind of get rid of those. Right? So this guy, very, very, very lightly. Oh, don't even barely touch him. Come over here. So soft. So soft. And any amount of the light color that you bring down, you can always tap out, turn into foam. So don't worry about that. Okay? We started coming up over here. I can tell just by my angles down that I need to come up this way. So soft, so soft.
Thank you so much for sending the gifts, guys. We really appreciate it.
Oh, we love you guys.
Josh does do this on his free time. And the bigger the gift, the louder noise I make. So if I annoy you, I'm sorry.
There we go. So now, doesn't matter about these little nicks and stuff, right? London does get very excited. And I love her for that. Man, that looks so cool. Just like the mountain is floating in the water. Okay, now we're going to come in with our brush. We're just going to use the tip top. Just the top, like 20, 30 bristles, maybe 100 at the top here. Everyone see these gorgeous things?
Hey, babe, could you explain what wet-on-wet technique is?
So wet-on-wet is we started with a wet canvas. I covered it with this clear medium, Bob Ross oil paint. It's clear medium that we started with, and that way the canvas was slick, and then we're taking wet paint and putting it onto a wet surface, so wet-on-wet. And that helps all of these colors blend together. You can move things, you can change things.
Hey, we
you
got
can
a pizza.
Go back. Hey, a pizza! That's my favorite.
Hannah loves Santa pizza.
I love pizza. My goodness. See how we're coming up and just tapping into here, bringing some of that mist down, and then we can go back in, and it's like it's just a lot of fog. And then we'll come back and add our horizon line and stuff. But again, coming up, grabbing some of the white color, dragging it down.
Hey guys, if you're in the live on TikTok, please follow our top gifters. Right now, our top gifters are Hannah Love.
Hey, thank ya.
And bear with me one second.
What, you leave those
and Rosanna Pina.
Every time I'm tapping, guys, you need to be tapping on the screen, by the way.
Doc Pope also sent a gift. If you send a gift, we do reciprocate. We will get you more followers if we can through our own lives.
Yeah,
just
we
being
try.
So great within the live.
We try for sure. Man,
there's a hair from the brush on the left and it's bothering me.
Right here? Guy Raymond for you. He's gone. Anything else anyone's bothered by? All right.
Probably just my voice, but it's...
No, well, you guys can eat it because that's my wife and I love her. All right, we're going to take a very small fan brush now because I don't want these trees to get too big, right? If you take a big fan brush, see how small this guy is? And I'm going to try to use half for the top of the tree and half for the reflections because I want the trees to be very far away. If you make the trees very tall, then that makes them seem very close, which makes your mountain seem smaller because it's so much closer. So we're going to take that same... Yeah, see, now that we have a lot of that light color in here, that reflective light color, we can put a dark section of trees. And I'm not covering the whole brush, just up to the top. Everybody see?
Caitlin says she's bothered by you not doing the Ryan Reynolds voice.
I'm sorry, Caitlin. This is Ryan Reynolds, owner of Boost Mint Mobile T-Mobile Mix Mobile Arena in whatever we're just here to do a nice little mountain and a couple trees. So, just for Christina, her name is Christina?
Caitlin,
just for you, Caitlin. We're going to come in and do a couple little trees. It's going to be fantastic. Are you ready? Are you ready? All right, so again, a little bit of paint on the brush.
Ryan Reynolds got a Wayne Static right there.
I have no idea.
You're like, are you ready?
Are you ready? Ah! Go to James Hetfield. Yeah!
If you guys can follow our top gifters, that would be Hannah Love, Rosanna Pina, and Crystal. All sent gifts through the live. If you send a gift, I will give you a shout out.
You guys are awesome. Shout outs for gifting.
We're currently at 34,000 likes on TikTok.
Oh, come on, guys. You got to tap. We had like 180,000 taps on one live one day. So come on, we got to beat that record.
We got to try and get that post 180,000.
Now we're going to take our 2-inch brush, just like this. We're going to come in here. We're going to take them, kind of go halfway. So get some out of the water, leaving half of those reflections, just very lightly pulling up. Look how it instantly turns them into these sharp treetop looking deals. Very pointy at the top. It's gorgeous. 100 million trees back there. Now we're going to grab the other side. Gonna pull down and decide very softly. The more you pull, the longer they're gonna get. Gonna cover up all that color.
Craig Genie on Facebook says, are you still buying Bob Ross products or do you have them stockpiled?
I've got a bunch. I've got boxes of stuff. My fans send me brushes and I'm not gonna turn down a free brush. But yeah, I've got tons and tons of paint that's still Bob Ross stuff. And not that I don't like the paint, I use them all. I use Gamblin. There's actually Gamblin Phthalo Green mixed in with the Bob Ross Phthalo Green that we have, because the Bob Ross Phthalo Green came out very oily in this tube. I hadn't mixed it enough, you know what I mean? But I use them all. The white that's in here is Winsor & Newton. So you don't have to just use one brand. I mix them up and use them all. And then we use another brand sometimes called Magic Fly. And those are really cool. They're like, you could get like gold and silver, all these cool, neat little colors, copper, stuff like that, like different little things that you could use to highlight your red mountains and stuff. It's really neat. So very softly along the bottom, swipe those reflections, and now it even looks like we got this mist rolling in. That might inspire me to do something else. Maybe that mist came up here. And I could pop a big tree in front of it. Very cool. All right, now again, I don't want to do too much over here. So what do we do? What do we do, Josh? I could throw an iceberg out in the middle. It'd be cool. Call it done. All right. Let's see. I'm going to take a step back every so often and see what the heck to do. There we go. Every so often you come back and you got to be very careful. Very careful when you come back, because if you come back and you touch something, it's really going to make you just really annoyed. So anytime you come back, don't touch anything. Don't touch the mountain. Don't touch the clouds. Don't touch anything, right?
Don't touch the moon.
Don't touch the moon. And then if you do happen to touch it like this, right? That's going to be the best TikTok I've ever made. If you do happen to touch it like this, you can always go back and just soften it a little bit. Mix it. Or come back, take your knife.
Better Butternut there with the chilies. Go ahead and throw her a follow as well. We've got Better Butternut, Hannah Love,
Better
Rosanna
Butternut,
Pina, and Crystal.
Very cool. Just fix the whole thing from swiping it, right? Very neat. Very neat. All right, let's throw in a couple little things down around the bottom.
Nicole
says, bring in a couple trees over here.
Will this painting be on Etsy to purchase?
Yes, ma'am. This painting will go on Etsy within an hour of me ending the live show. I take a couple pictures of it, and then I go downstairs. We create the Etsy listing. It goes out on Etsy, and then I post it to Facebook and Instagram and all my other platforms with the link. So it's like a race. If you want it, you really got to be there. So paintwithjosh.etsy.com. If you really want this painting, and maybe, you know, 30 minutes to an hour after we go live, just sit there and refresh. It'll eventually pop up. Okay, we're going to take that dark color again, and let's save that room for a big tree. So maybe we'll come over here and throw some closer trees. We're going to come up just slightly over here. Bam. Throw our first guy in, and I can't do it that way. I have to do it this way, so I'm going to try to show you guys, try to stay as far away so there's no shadow. We're just coming up and just touching in at the top, which makes my trees start to, you know, you really gotta find your groove. And sometimes you guys can't see the tip top when I'm making it. So, you know, I try to show you everything, but I can't do a tree without kind of getting in the way sometimes. So
We do have a couple of new gifters. Again, shoot that follow over to Better Butternut, Hannah Love, Cheryl, Rosanna, Pina. If I'm saying that wrong, please correct me
is
in the comments.
Is it Pina with like a...
Yes.
It's got to be Pina with a... Pina. That's NY correct. Sound.
Yes. Which is also the name of my favorite actor, so you'd think I'd know that.
You would.
Crystal.
Okay, can I come up again? A little bit bigger. Give this guy a friend. Come in, just tapping so lightly with the corner. And then as you get down, you just start using more of the brush. Push a little bit harder. Push a little bit harder like that, right? Can everyone see? I'm trying to show you. See how we're rotating the brush? But I'm really only using a small amount. I'm not using the full bristles until we get down around the bottom. And then all of our little branches start to shine through, right? So let's wash that brush off. Get that old nasty brush out of the way. Comes out nice and clean. Fantastic. Fantastic indoor swap meet. All right. Now, we're going to put a little highlight on that guy. So, we need to take another small brush, right? A smaller brush. We use the bigger brush to create the shadow. Now we need to use a smaller brush in order to create the details on the tree. Otherwise, they start to mix together and just look too big and you lose all the cool little details. So very small amount of liquid white. It's not a whole lot on the brush. I'm gonna come into our white over here. Maybe take one little smidge of our phthalo green color just so it's off white, it's not pure white. Come back over here. Not loading the brush completely, just a little bit. We just got little trees over here, right? Maybe this guy we're gonna tap on the top just to kind of create the tip top of his trunk. That gives us an idea about where we can start to highlight him, right? Maybe we'll come in, and he's not our foreground tree, so he doesn't need a whole lot of highlights on him, right? You don't need to see everything. Just a couple little dabs, though. It's not too much, and we're still leaving some shadowed area of the tree.
Hey, babe, we have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
How long do your paintings take to dry before you can send them out?
So these take about 2 to 3 days. I don't know why. I don't know if it's because I stretch the oil or how much we work it. Or that the arid temperature or, you know, the arid climate of Las Vegas, for whatever reason, these oil paintings are dry very quickly and they're able to be sent out within a few days.
Doesn't that have something to do with the amount of paint that you put on a canvas, babe?
True. It does have, you know, if your trees are very thick and very textured, it's going to take a long time for those trees to dry versus the thinner parts of your painting. It's the same like this. Have you ever left your palette? You ever left your palette just like this, and walked away, forgot about it, and then you came back and you had to scrape all this stuff off, right? The stuff, and maybe some of it was still wet, because the thin stuff dries very quickly, right? Once you spread it out as far as it can spread, it dries very fast. Maybe this thicker pile might still be wet, all these big piles might still be wet, but these very thin areas are gonna be dry and I'm gonna really have to scrape them. So it depends on the Blendman's right, the amount of paint on your brush, the amount of paint on your canvas, how thick it is, and you know, I don't wanna go too far down the bottom. Maybe the bottom of this guy is very shadowy. But yeah, thank you, honey.
So we ran a poll, babe, and the poll said, would you buy paint with Josh Paints? And currently we're at 75% yes. If you would be interested in purchasing paint with Josh Paints, please write in the comments, yes to paints.
Yes to paints. Yeah, I think that that thing was like a scam, though.
I don't think it was a scam.
We'd have to purchase, you know, a bunch. But yeah.
We're really going to have this conversation.
No, we're not having it right now. Okay. Thanks. Let's go right here. We're going to drop in just a little bit of land. Ooh, that looks cool. Ooh, right? That looks neat. Let's put another little tree out there just to get rid of some of these reflections. So a little bit of black. Even if you don't have enough, you can just literally grab just a couple swipes of each, mix them up right here in this dark pile. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, ladies. Back and forth, just like that. I know you guys like it. All right, let's go in here. And I don't want to make him too tall, right? If you go like, it's going to look funny. So maybe pick a size in between or pick a smaller size. Maybe this guy on the end, he just had like a little bit of lean out into the water. He's like, oh no, I'm falling away. So we're going to come in here very lightly, very small amounts of paint.
Did a dinosaur step on him too?
Yeah, a dinosaur stepped on him when he was little. Little.
Tarican Pride is in the house. Hello.
Hello. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. We're doing a cool little Christmassy scene. That's kind of cool right here. Get a little bit of that liquid white back on the brush. Don't need a whole lot. Again, I'm going to come up, touch the tip of him so we can see where the top of his trunk is. He's a very small little guy. And then maybe just a couple dabs with just the corner of the brush. Right? And I'm just tapping up because, again, these guys are very far away. And so if you add too many details, they're just not going to look right. Right? Maybe this guy got a little bit fatter on the bottom. Just a touch. Bam. There we go. Wicked. And you don't even have to show the whole rest of him, right? You're going to take him out. Be very flat. And then the more that we do this, the more you can kind of create. It will come down around here into the foreground. Be very cool. So again, taking the very smallest amount of paint on the brush, pulling it back, grabbing a new dry 1-inch brush, right? Maybe starting from back here. Now I'm going to knock the paint off of that real fast. Otherwise, I'm going to deposit a bunch of it back out here as I do it. So knock it off. Knock it off over there. There we go. Make it nice and soft. And then back here, who knows? We'll do like a, it'll start to wrap itself into something.
If you guys think that Josh's voice is calming and watching him paint is calming you, please head over to youtube.com/paintwithjosh, where he has hundreds, literally hundreds
literally
of videos.
300 videos.
Not my voice is not in the back of all of them, so it will just be him. If you join the subscription model over on YouTube, you will see numerous videos with super high definition zoom ins and in-depth tutorials for you.
Yeah, every time that we come in to touch the canvas, the camera zooms in, and then you get these cool things that you can see much more up close, right? Can everyone see?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we're gonna go, I guess we can still see the whole canvas.
If you are on Facebook wondering how to send stars, down the bottom there should be a little symbol that looks like a star. If you click on that, it'll show you how to purchase the stars so you can send them during the live. You can also send stars after the live and on any video that you see of Josh's. It does massively help if you share, like, comment, and subscribe to any of the channels. That is completely free to do. So please keep that in mind when you come across other platforms. To follow, drop that individual a follow. I mean, yeah, obviously Josh, but take it into consideration when you see other people's artwork as well.
Everybody needs a follow. Oh, this would be cool. Yeah. Okay, we're going to have a cool little lake back here with a nice little waterfall coming down. This way? Or no? There we go. Just trying to make it soft, give it a couple little differences in color, different things happening. Oh, that looks really cool. Now that's giving me an idea. We could just highlight the top of this guy. A little bit brighter white. Now you got a cool little bit of shadow on top of whatever little hill this was.
Just a reminder, Josh does do this in his free time, so gifts, stars, super stickers on YouTube do really help.
They really do, you guys.
And they do really help with the income that he generates from his artwork. So if you are able to, whether or not it's a rose, whether or not it's a $1 super sticker, whether it's 99 stars on Facebook, if you can gift, please do.
Yeah, it goes towards buying more supplies, buying more canvases, doing more cool free shows and different things.
Keeping the internet on.
Keeping the internet on so we can do shows. All right, let's scrape up a little bit of dark, just like that, right on the end of our knife. And we'll come in, maybe decide where we want our little bit of shoreline to be. And by dropping in that dark color, it provides a little depth, a little shadow, right? And we're gonna just so softly, very softly, just pulling them down just to soften it a little bit. And the more you pull it down, the bigger your drop is gonna seem, right? So. If you pull it down humongously, you'll have this big giant cliff.
Tamika says, how long have y'all been together?
So we've been together
12 years.
We've been together a long time. We've been together for like 12 years, on and off. We got divorced for a couple years, and then we got back together because she loves me so much.
Yeah. We can go with that.
Patsy Dean says, London, I can always tell when Josh is live. I don't hear from Jonathan for an hour.
Ah, that's funny. That's her husband. Because he loves watching the Paint with Josh shows.
How much does a painting cost, babe?
So they all vary. It's hard to tell. Like, if we spent a long time doing this one and it came out really fantastic, it's going to be worth a little bit more than ones that we do in half an hour. You know what I mean? So it's hard to say. But I'm running a 30% off sale in my store right now. So you can go over and check it out. These ones are probably I don't even know percentages. That's why I get... I'm like, I don't want to say because I'll tell you something and then you guys are going to know that I'm dumb and I can't do math. but yeah, they're usually about between $149 to $179 for a size this big. So 30% off of that, I don't know what it is. I mean, if you guys know, then that would be great. We're going to take a little bit of this down. That light color just underneath the dark color. Maybe it might look like the little reflection of something. Now, when I don't get all the color off that brush, you can start to transfer too much color everywhere the more color you have on your brush. So I'm just going to wipe it off on a paper towel. There we go. Like, really wipe it off, though. Very softly go over those guys.
We got a paper crane!
Hey, that's wicked. Thank you.
I love paper cranes. Hey, guys, remember that if you submit gifts, I will instruct everybody to drop you a follow. So Better Button Up, we've got Better Button Up in place number one. We've got St. Julian's in place number two with that paper crane. We've got Hannah Love, Spirit Weaver, Crystal, Rosanna Pena, and then Dark Pope.
Dark Pope?
Shoot those guys a follow. They're doing great work within the live.
You guys are awesome, and we appreciate it. Look at these little differences in angle, right? Starting up here, swiping down, and all of a sudden we've created this little ridge back here. And this shadow is looking less and less like a shadow. There we go. I wanted it to have this cool little shadowy effect, but maybe it was too much. Excellent. Look at these little differences. You don't have to make them all the same, right? You don't have to make it all the same. We can drag this guy all the way over here and just start to change our angles upwards. And then all of a sudden it's going to look a little bit different, right? But it's the same thing. If you're going like that, your angles over here have to be the same in order to change it and create that little ridge that's going to grow itself around.
We got
right?
Crystal with those cat paws.
You're awesome, you guys. You are awesome.
Coming in hot.
Coming in hot.
Coming in hot with the cat paws.
There we go. Differences in color, though, right?
That looks lovely, babe.
That looks cool, right?
That looks super cool.
And what's funny is I can't even see it on the camera because the iPad's in the way. There
right,
we go.
It's lovely.
So I don't even know what
oh,
it looks
yeah,
like.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Hee, hee. There we go.
Can I not make it taller? I can make it taller.
Wrapping that around, just letting it blend out, and then we'll see what it looks like.
Can I make it taller?
Yeah, it might be a pain in the butt, though. There we go. All these little differences in color, little ridges in our mountain, little things happening.
There you go, my love.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Now I can see. Excellent.
You're welcome.
Now I can see. Okay. You're welcome.
You're welcome.
All right, we're going to do a big thing over here that's going to connect to this piece of land that's coming around.
Burnett says, can you do animals?
Oh, no. Ask my wife.
Oh,
my wife will very clearly tell you I cannot do animals.
Fun story. Josh attempted once to paint an elephant, and... He came down, he goes, babe, what do you think of this? And I looked at him and said, have you ever seen an elephant before?
She's horrible to me.
That's just the truth, babe. I'm not going to let you make a fool of yourself. Like,
horrible to me.
I'm really not.
Oh, I know. She's so sweet. There we go. A little bit of water maybe at the edge. Depends. What do you think it is? Do you think it's a little bit of water coming in, or do you think it's a little bit of snow reflection or light?
Better Butternut coming in with those cake slices.
Woo! Man, that looks really, really, really cool, you guys. Really cool. So softly. So soft. Otherwise, it will literally blend away, and you won't have, you know, anything.
Better Butternut's begging for a UFO.
Oh, goodness. She said that last night, and I don't know. I don't think, I mean, maybe if we had a bidding war, you know, adding a UFO really takes it away from a lot of people wanting to buy it. And since it's the Christmas season, you know, I mean, I do reach that group that is into the UFOs like me and wants to buy it for that, but more people are not, you know what I mean? So if someone's like, hey, I might really buy this one, don't add a UFO, I really don't want a UFO, then I might not. And if someone was like, hey, I really want to buy it with a UFO in it, then that's another story.
We could add it all to the
paint.
Fact.
It's true, we could always add one afterwards. Let's put another couple little guys in here. Don't want to do too many, and I don't want to go too high up. Right down there.
If you guys are interested to see how Josh got into painting, there is a little intro over on his TikTok page. It's a little sad.
It's a little sad intro, but it's necessary. See how we come down, we pop it back and forth.
It's going to be a no for the UFO. There's currently a poll going on TikTok that says no for UFO.
Well, then a UFO it is. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Nice thick bit of tree. Every so often, if you can get a little branch to come out. Branch, my man.
Branch.
And then we'll go back and highlight it. Maybe we'll put one more next to him. One more little guy. Maybe
you
a medium-sized guy.
67,000 likes over on TikTok.
Woo, hit that tap button, you guys.
If you could do me a huge favor and hit that share button, send it out to some people and say, hey, this guy's super relaxing. He sort of sounds like Bill Hader and Ryan Reynolds.
And Bob Ross. Heath Ledger.
His paintings are amazing. If you could shoot that out to some of your friends and see if we can get them in here too, that would be amazing.
That would be super.
Thanks, Dad, for tapping the screen. Dope. Really appreciate it.
There we go. Another little guy.
Like, if my father's in here tapping the screen, there is zero reason why you too cannot tap the screen.
There we go.
And he's a frozen ice block in England.
It's very cold over there. All right, now we're going to throw one little piece of something maybe off that side. This almost makes me want to connect it and throw a waterfall in here, but our perspective is already flat. So we can't, unless I raise the level of the land higher, a waterfall wouldn't make sense here. I've been trying to think if I could do it.
Leave the reflection and then where the trees are, put a shoreline in.
Back here?
Yeah.
Yeah, way in the back. Well, I mean, yeah, I should have done that before, dang it.
Well, here we are now.
So, yeah, I mean, the initial shoreline back there would be about here. Right, way off in the distance. Not perfectly straight. Going to try to not touch the tree. Oh! I touched the tree!
No, babe!
That's all right, I could fix that.
Don't touch the butt.
That's going to be a funny TikTok, too.
Don't touch the butt.
Yeah, he touched the butt. Everyone that kept saying, oh, you touched the moon, just kept reminding me, you touched the butt.
Don't touch the butt. We have officially hit 50,500 followers.
Wow, you guys are killer. That's awesome.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Just the smallest little bit of light being pulled down just to show you back where those reflections are. And then we'll just swipe across. It's so light. Don't touch the tree. Ooh. Touched it again. There we go. Okay. Now, we've got a very far away thing. I do need to bring something in from over here. Now that our shoreline is that high, and I'm going to have a big tree. So why don't we do... Oh, this is going to be fun. Why don't we do a big old... Like a... I don't know. Like a rock or something.
Hey, babe. The
tree's going to sit on top. Yeah, honey?
The intro video of how you got into painting. Did you ever post that to Facebook?
I thought I did. We put it everywhere.
Maybe we didn't.
Yeah. If we didn't, we can post it again.
Yeah.
I mean, on Facebook, it's hard because everything gets kicked down so quickly.
That is true.
Okay, I'll take this over here. Maybe we'll do... Let's do the tree first. Maybe we'll do this big guy up here. Come in. Right? I'm not going to go all the way to the bottom because I'm going to have something else here. So again, we're going to come in. We're going to tap up very lightly. And every so often, you throw a little bigger tap in there. That gives you those cool little branches that stick out, right? You come down again. A little bit more cool little branches, but you need that color way off in the distance, right? And we're literally slapping at the tree to create these little things, just on an angle.
Right? Okay, coming down. Silence for the ASMR.
Shh, just like that, very cool.
Babe,
yeah.
The point of ASMR is you shut up.
funny. All right, let's shape this rock. Look, just again, it doesn't even matter what your rock looks like is the point I'm making, right? Only just deciding what the, you know, what the top edge looks like. And then we can always hide the rest, keep it down here in deep darkness. Maybe we'll have it come around. I like that. That's a very cool little scene. You know what? This thing is just, this is just too bright. I'm only going to save the smallest little bit. Here we go. Oh, we can even have two. We can have, all right, we're going to have the teeniest, tiniest little babbling waterfall in there.
Have you been into art your whole life? Does wifey paint too?
Wifey does not paint, and no, I have not been into art my whole life. The pin video in my on my TikTok will tell you how I got into art. You know, it's a very sad story. But yeah, that'll tell you how I came to come across Bob Ross and how we started painting and, you know, where we led to now. It's only been 3.5 years.
Dad says, I like it.
Thanks, Dad.
Picasso.
Picasso. All right, we're going to scrape up a little bit of that white, just like that. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Going to come in here very lightly, just barely touching. Look, that one didn't even grab anything. See what I mean?
Better Butternut would like to know how much this would be if you put a UFO in it.
Ooh, well,
$1 million.
Yeah.
I don't know why I had the Dr. Evil response.
Yes. It would probably be about, I can't do math, so it'd probably be about 169 if we added a UFO and it looked really good. There we go. Of course it would look good because
you did it.
Look at that cool little things you can start to, just by making a mess, right? Maybe this guy over here started to flatten out.
Hey, babe, you know what you should do?
What?
On the left-hand side of the canvas, you should put a North Star.
Okay, I can do that.
Thanks, TikTok, for the suggestion. They're like, we just said that.
All right, watch this. Left side of the canvas, North Star, will have this little guy pointing at it.
Crystal just said to Dad, is your profile, is the... The dog in your profile picture, is that Gibbs?
That's Gibbs.
My dad's going to be like, who is Crystal?
Right.
I talk about you a lot, Dad.
Just up and down, just like that. And go right into the middle.
Hold on. Stop. They can't see now because I moved the...
Oh.
1, 2, 3. Revelation of the North Star.
Bam. So yeah, again, just with the knife. Up and down. You can even go a little... crisscross if you want.
Alex, that's all you, because I moved the camera just for you, because you are so nicely, and then
like that.
Forgot that we've moved it. That's adorable.
Yeah, get this cool thing happening up
here. Hey, babe, you know what would be good in this?
What's up? Glitter. Oh, that's a good idea, too. Oh, yeah. Glitter for the holidays. Okay, we're going to grab a little bit of blue. We need to make up a few deep, darker shadows in here with this blue color. Don't need a whole lot of paint, and I probably want to use our smaller knife. Since we're gonna go into smaller areas, right? Like back in here, I'm taking some of that and just accentuating that shadowy color with that blue in there. A little piece underneath. Little things happening, right? Which is why I like to do the shadows beforehand, because then you can just come in with your highlights and not have to sneak them into places. You know, you can just roll right over the top of them. But sometimes we'll do it this way too. Just let them mix in. It's all shadowy back there, right? It doesn't have to be a definitive line between the shadows and the highlights. Almost looks like a little cave in there. Ooh, that looks neat. Watch this. Ooh, we're gonna take a little bit of that greenish on our knife. And just from back in here, pop a little cave. Like you'd be able to see the water coming out. That's kind of cool. All right, let's get a little bit more darkness underneath here. That way we'll have something to pull outwards, like a cool little bit of cave right there. All right, let me come back very lightly, swipe up. How long have we been going for?
Who cares?
Who cares?
We have been going for 55 minutes. Trying to get the whole canvas and the phone, it's hard.
Yeah.
For anyone, the 86 people that are watching on TikTok, if you could follow Billy Big Chunks so that he could go live, I promise you
his
live videos would be hilarious.
Thing. Billy Big Chunks is my father-in-law, and he is so funny. Where do you think London got his where do you think London got her sense of humor from? She got it from him. He's funny.
Dad might need to change his name to Billy is hilarious.
Billy is hilarious. I'm gonna take this guy. He's got just a couple little details out that way. Very cool. Can you see that it maybe goes under? You know what actually we're gonna do?
Oils with Mick, by the way, who has 26,000 followers.
Hey, Oils with Nick.
Mick.
Mick. Oils with Mick.
M like Mike.
Got it.
It says, what size is this canvas? 16 by 20?
18 by 24.
Manny Presh says, did you know Bob Ross personally?
No. Oh, my goodness. If I did, you guys, I wouldn't even know what to do. I really want to close this off, but is it going to make sense to have two
Oh, my goodness. Aaron Kenny just sends $5.
Oh, my God.
Through YouTube.
Hey, thank you, man. Super stickers are where it's at.
Jackie Causa says, baking goods while watching you live. Jackie, by all means, if you want to send us a DM, I'll send you the address. You can put them in a freeze pack box. And
yeah,
send us
some baked goods. If we just like, if we can come up here like this and just create like this little shelf.
Caitlin's like, we have indeed heard a lot about you and Gibbs.
Oh my goodness. We're going to connect him with a bridge, guys. Oh, I just see this.
A little bridge?
I see it in my head.
A little bridge?
Oh, I see it in my head.
Everyone's saying, no, don't close it.
So yeah, no, we're not closing it. We're not closing it. We're going over it. We're going over it, baby.
Thank you so much for all the gifts. Really appreciate it.
And then we can always come back and adjust. Very cool. Very cool. Now, again, in order to have it look like there's something sitting up there, you have to have it dark, right? And maybe get the light to just come over. Look at that. The more you mix it in, the darker it becomes. So be careful. Get it right on your first go.
Oh my goodness. Greetings from Switzerland.
Hey, Switzerland. Maybe we wouldn't see all of that snow, right? You can always go back and play with it until it starts to look right in your mind.
Caitlin says, can we get a little shooting star top center too, or would that be too much?
Let's see.
Bink.
Don't want to have too much paint on it. That's probably too much paint. Touch it to a paper towel, make it go away. Don't want to have too much paint on it, right? Just like this. And come in here. Where are we going to put a shooting star? Throw it right there. Just drop a little dot, okay? That's all you need. One little dot. Now we're going to come over. We're going to grab our filbert brush. We're going to grab our maul stick. We're going to come up here. Just like so. Nothing on the brush. And grab it and flick it. So put your maul stick far enough away that you're not going to go and hit your stick, right? Don't hit the stick. Don't touch the moon. Look, you can rotate this thing as far as you want. As long as there's a little bit of room underneath, then you have somewhere hard to rest. And then it's like drawing with a pencil, and you can get very fine little details like that, right? We're going to come over here. We're going to grab it. Flick. A soft little shooting star back there. And then depends on how you shape it and rotate it, right? That almost looks like a bird. Maybe we should do that again. Watch this.
You mean if you do something in oils that you don't like, you can just scrub it
yeah,
out with a brush?
Just brush it out. Look, and now
that's
it's
amazing.
And now it's blended in with that other bit of, you know.
So there was a shooting star, now no shooting star.
Yeah, you should have seen the live last night. I put a UFO in across the birds, and I'm gonna go back to the same spot. This time I want to add a little bit of a tail to it, just so we can grab a little bit. That liquid white really wants to disappear so fast. But I put a UFO in it on top of the birds, and then I didn't like it, so I scrubbed it all out. I'm gonna grab this guy.
Glenn's asking me if I liked Walter.
Oh, I gotta show you still. I haven't shown her yet, Glenn. I still gotta show her. I lose, dude, I got a lot of stuff going on in my brain, and I lose track of stuff. Walter's the little bird that he paints into his scenes, he was saying.
I know.
Yeah, so he sent me a picture of what it looked like close up, so okay. I can show you. Okay, one soft, so soft. Just like that. Cool. Shooting star. The more you pull it, the longer it's going to become. And then again, anything you don't like around it, just take and blend it away.
Do the smudgy, smudgy, smudge.
A little smudgy, smudge. All right. How many people we got watching?
77 on TikTok.
Awesome.
We've got 27 on Facebook, and we've got
16 on YouTube.
Awesome.
If you guys can hit that thumbs up over there on YouTube, unless you don't like it, in which case I advise you to go find something you do enjoy, that would be a massive help. Angela Bassant is from Ontario.
Thanks for tuning in. There we go. Does it look like there's a little bit of reflection? Like this thing is a little bridge. Maybe if we went like this. Yeah? Yeah, maba? Meba? If we pulled it down just a touch, pulled it over to the side.
Hey, babe.
Does that look like a little bridge now?
Greasy PC says, painting is ruined.
Why?
I don't know.
That's all good. You don't like it, you don't have to buy it. There you go. Very cool. We just got to make it look right in our brains, right? So maybe.
Oils with mix says, what's the hardest thing to paint in wet on wet?
Well, it depends. I mean.
Elephants?
Struggle with a lot of stuff. You know what I mean?
Struggle bus to Elephant Town?
There's many things that I've struggled with. It all depends. Some people don't struggle with things. Some people do. All depends on what's hard for you. I think clouds are kind of easy when some people think that they're difficult. I think mountains are kind of easy when other people think that they're difficult. So, you know, what do I find difficult?
Josh and his magic paintbrush. Doop.
It's hard. It's hard to say. It's hard to say for sure. Let's get a little bit more of that blue on this side. There we go. I think this little addition is making the painting better, if you ask
Oils
me.
With Mix says, for me, it's still life. Yeah, 100%.
Oh, well, yeah, for sure. I only paint landscapes, so.
Yeah. No life over here.
No. I have no life. There we go. Soft little things, leaving those little dark areas. Don't make those colors connect. That adds the depth. Alright, maybe we had a little bit more of a bit of rock come down. There we go. Makes more sense in my brain. And that's what it's about, making sense in your own brain. And adding that little bit of darkness, that little bit of shadows, a little bit of depth to it, right? And not going all the way down to the bottom. You don't have to cover everything. Very cool.
Art by Elise says, I'm so glad I came over to your TikTok. Now I have problems leaving it.
Ha ha! That's funny. Well, I appreciate you staying and hanging out with us. A little bit too much paint. So look, we're going to scrape up all that paint and come back over here and try to get it done in just a couple swipes. There we go.
Glenn says, I like this. This one tutorial I will be doing.
Hey!
For anyone who's super interested in learning more about painting, Josh has a 12-day challenge happening right now. We are on day 10, so you've got 5 days to submit 12 paintings. We will be doing a drawing on the 24th of December live.
Is that Christmas Eve, babe?
It is. During the live SantaDay, in order to give away a hooded sweatshirt, which we don't have.
Paint my Josh hoodie.
Is that one?
Yeah, it's up here.
Oh, okay, cool.
Well, this is my one. You guys can't have this one. But paint with Josh hoodie, and yours will say something different. It's custom.
It'll say the winner of the 12-day painting challenge.
Yeah, it's wicked. Now it probably has paint all over it.
That's right.
Okay, let's see. Let's see what to do, what to do. All right. Now, you kind of got to soften these guys a little bit. Look at this.
Ken Monk says, I challenge you to use water mixable oils with the wet on wet using 50% zinc white and 50% linseed oil. You need no harsh chemicals. Josh doesn't use any harsh chemicals.
Yeah, I mean, we have the low odor mineral spirits or the odorless mineral spirits, but they don't.
But he doesn't mix them with his paint.
Yeah, I mean, when you do the thing, but yeah, it's not anything like.
Yeah, but you just use the oils straight out of the box. A lot of people mix them so that there's more of them.
Oh yeah, no, I just get it out and we rock and roll. All right, let's not forget about our little tree that's up here. That's throwing my brain off. Why it's so dark over here? So we're gonna grab a little bit of that.
There's no snow on it.
That little teeny guy, a little bit of the white. And we're going to come in here and I'm going to hit it right here. Bop, right on the top, just like that. Boop. Just so you get the little peak. Okay, now we're going to come in and we're going to start touching up very lightly with just a corner. Right? I don't want it to be too much. You don't have to cover every single thing. You want to have little things that are dark, little things that are light. Yeah, just like so, right? Little teeny tiny things.
Little teeny tiny things. A wicked glare on the...
Turn it this way. I can't move it.
Okay. Oils with mix says, what's the biggest canvas you've done?
For 36 by 48.
This is a big canvas.
It was a large canvas, that was for sure. We just recently did a 30 by 40, but it's not here to show you. Let me come down one more little thing. Yeah. There, now he's sitting up on top of that stone. Very cool. Except this guy needs more shadow back behind him.
Guys, don't forget to shoot our biggest gifters a follow. We've got Better Butternut, Red Bed Rebel,
Make sure
Ton of Love,
on that screen.
Spirit Weaver, Rosanna Pena, Dark Hope, and Oils with Mick. Shoot those guys a follow. Maybe we'll get you on a different side of TikTok for once. If your FYP is boring, then follow new people, get on a new side of TikTok.
Yeah, right.
And don't forget to tap that screen. We're at 77,000.
You guys, 77,000.
I thought you were going to bust into the Mariah Carey song right there.
Don't want to march for Christmas. No, people will leave immediately.
There is just one thing I need.
If it's me singing, everyone is leaving.
And I
don't hear Christmas.
Underneath the Christmas tree.
I like this one right here. And it's cool because you can just sit. I mean, you know, you don't want to add too much, and you definitely can add too much. So be careful, work at it, step back, look, check it out. Doesn't all have to be perfect, right?
90% of the people in the room say yes, they love this painting. 9% say not really.
That's okay. That's okay. You don't have to like it. Scrape in just a little water line, and then we can come down and kind of meet that section.
Stephanie, everything that you see here on TikTok will be posted as a video over on YouTube. We do take the live. We are streaming to 3 platforms and on Facebook and YouTube for the month of December only. All the lives are public view. Back to January, we will be subscription-based only. So if you want to catch the live and you miss the live, then you'll be able to join for the price of a small fancy coffee a month and watch as many tutorials as you like. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good. All right, let's go right here. And start covering in little things, little differences. We can do all sorts. I mean, you can end up covering this whole lake if you, or this whole little pond if you wanted to, but I don't want to get down that far.
Oils with Mick says, have you guys thought about doing in-person classes?
Yes, if the demand was there, we would definitely do an in-person class. We have a couple ideas, but yeah, I would love that. I would love to do an in-person class.
Hey, don't you have
you got a Zoom class tomorrow. Yeah. That's what she's going to. Zoom class tomorrow with one of the fans.
I don't have a Zoom class tomorrow. I have nap time tomorrow. While you have Zoom class.
I've got Zoom class. She's got nap class. Nappy class.
Shameless plug, if anyone in here is interested in having your house smell amazing, you can head over to etsy.com/thelondoncandleco and you can buy nice smelling candles for your house.
You can. They're fantastic.
I currently have a 50% off sale, so buy 4, pay for 2, and you'll love them.
They're really fantastic. There we go.
You will love them. If you do practice with family, I've done it. It's fun in person.
What?
In-person classes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's
fun. There's just the 3 of us. So, you know what you could do? You could recommend. Why don't you call Grandma or Grandpa and tell them that you want to set up an oil paint for everybody to do in Utah at the family reunion next year?
That would be cool.
That would be amazing. Plus the fact there'd be 50 people in that room.
Yeah, right?
All right, let's do this. That'd be a lot of supplies.
Well, you're not going to bring them all, are you?
No.
Well, I mean, we could.
Could, but here we go. We're going to come in. We're going to highlight these little guys. Little touches. Right? Little guys. Little things. These guys are further away. So I just tap up very slightly with the corner. And get these little globs. Gotta get some more paint.
You should have whispered that.
Whisper. Gotta get some more paint.
If he's tapping, you should be.
Yeah, right? Tap, tap, tap on the screen, guys. Yeah. Cool little things. Cool little bits of tree branch. Fantastic!
Mark Anderson says maybe it's the perspective they don't like.
Yeah, right.
Only joking, Joe.
I know. We get a lot of those.
Hey, the trash men are here.
Again. I thought the other one had come, but they had picked up. All right, we're going to come back from the water up into here. And then we're not going to mess with that anymore. That is fire.
Can we get some birds?
We will. Put that in here. A couple little things. Little imperfections. Little rolling hills, right? It's not ever all the same. Very softly, very lightly, trying to soften just a few of these little things. So soft. They're barely even touching it. No sound. Everything's soft.
Maybe we could do that in January. Plan a whisper only paint scene.
Yeah, right? That'd be cool.
Maybe you, well, I don't know if you could.
I'm not sure. You're saying you don't know if I could whisper?
I don't think you could whisper for an hour and a half.
Probably not.
I challenge you to a whisper only live. I don't think you'd be able to.
I like to have fun.
Oh, that is true. The pond is the shape of a heart.
Oh, super cute.
Yeah.
As I go change it.
No, don't change it. What on earth is that?
Who's here, my goodness?
No idea.
Don't they know we're doing a live show?
They care.
You're probably right. You probably don't care. It's adding a little bit of that light color, our white color snow. Just the different places to really brighten it up. All depends
the
on
the doorbell rang due to, he looks a bit more modern today, but his name is Santa. He's wearing a blue outfit. He drives a truck. It starts with the letter A on the side of the vehicle.
Oh, an Amazon truck?
Yes, babe.
That's funny. Here we go. Just like that. Does it look like there's some water back in here? Because that's what it should look like. There we go. Maybe bring that slightest bit out underneath. And that should look like some water.
There's 58 of us here on TikTok. If you guys could smash that, like, that tap button so we can get to 100,000.
Come on, guys.
Amazing.
For Saturday, SantaDay, Christmas seascape. Not a seascape. But whatever we're doing. Landscape, painting, awesome show. There we go. Very
England cool. One, France one.
It's like the lake sunk. And this pond was left.
I like it that it looks like the snow is like melted.
Yeah, right. Very cool.
Jackie Causa says, really love this one. Gonna try it after I get the 12 days done.
Yeah. There we go.
Thank goodness. Denise Dischenis, if I said that wrong, I'm so sorry, says, do you paint animals? I think it's time for the elephant story again.
Oh my goodness. No, we do not.
There once was a time, long, long ago, within the last 36 months, where Josh brought a canvas downstairs and said, babe, look, I painted an elephant. To which London responded, have you ever seen an elephant? That was the end of paint with Josh in animal format.
Yeah. No more animals after that. No more animals after that.
Uh-oh. Oils with Mick says, I challenge Josh to do a Southwest scene. Canyons, cactus, and rocks.
Okay.
He must be new here.
I know. Who do you think you
he
are?
He must be new here.
What, you think I can't do it, Nick?
Mick?
Mick?
Why do you keep calling him Nick? England just scored against France. That makes me happy. Babe.
Yeah.
We should show him Saguaro.
Oh, the Saguaro one? Yeah.
Yeah.
So something like you're saying, Nick, but instead,
Mick.
But instead, the cactuses are lit cigars.
Whoop, whoop.
Fantastic. But yeah, this is from like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Way back when I very first started.
It's so old, it has a price tag on it.
Yeah. That means it's been to many shows and never sold. There we go. A little
but
projection
what we,
out there.
What we could do, Mick, is we could do a host live. You have enough followers. There's no reason why we couldn't set that up.
How many followers is Mick?
26,000. Uh-huh. 29,000, I'm sorry.
Oh, excuse you, London.
Yeah, no, I got that wrong. I'm sorry.
There we go. Mix it in like that. And take a little bit of our blue, because you got to have some shadows in there, too.
Burnett says, can we see the elephants? No, the elephants no longer exist.
Those elephants were...
They were unalived in the trash.
It went straight into the garbage. With that elephant. Perfection. Okay, I like that. Maybe we'll take just a little bit of brighter water around the edge.
Glenn, you totally could... happily add a cabin, a building, or a church.
Ooh,
on the
definitely.
Lower right.
On the lower
great.
Right?
No, I think
in mine.
It's that side.
Oh, on this
looking
side.
At it. Yeah.
Lower left. Yeah, mine's a lot. There's a lot of paint over here. I wouldn't try to put anything else on top of that. Oh, no, we got a bristle.
Not
a bristle.
A bristle, babe.
Oh, he's like wedged in there.
Oils with Mick says, I'd love to.
Do that.
Ooh.
That's a
it's
wicked
a
long...
painting.
A wicked long bristle. Now it's messed up my
Tune
little area.
Tune in to watch Babe with Josh do his hairy paintings.
Hairy paintings.
Jackie Causa says, how many people would it take to make it worth a class?
Well, I mean, it all depends, because you got to buy, you got to rent out the venue that you're doing, right? You have to have a place to have the class.
I would say probably, like, I tried to do this math the other day, just because I was bored. I would say 35 is the sweet number.
Yeah.
35 people at $100 a piece, provide the supplies.
Here we go. Look at all the paint we just scraped off. It's getting too hard to highlight it.
I would say 35 people.
So 35, because you got to buy, you got to rent out your space.
And then buy
the supplies. That means I would need to spend a whole lot in brushes. You could bring your own brushes, which would be helpful. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it's... add in a little bit of darkness here because we need some more shadowing. So yeah, maybe about 35 people plus. I mean, travel. That's if it's in Las Vegas, right? Like, we don't have to travel and ship.
Yeah, if we did it elsewhere, it would need to be 50 people minimum at $100 a person.
Yeah, because we have to take the easel. We have to.
Who, I'm sorry. Who's we?
Me and you are
what
going.
What do you mean me and you are going?
Absolutely. I'm not going to do it by myself.
No, I'm not
going to. I'm afraid.
I'm not going to stand up. What am I supposed to do? Bring my sweatpants and just sit on the floor?
Yeah, and respond to comments. Respond to comments and we'll show it live.
I'll be like, the person in row 3-4 over has a question.
That's funny. They're like, yes? Person in the back?
We'd have to get you one of those.
No, what I would want, no, seriously, what I would want is the place would have to have a TV where I could connect a camera and, you know, put it on a big screen so people all the way in the back could see. I would not want people coming up and check or watching me do like a certain thing and then everyone going back to their seat.
Right.
Like, that would be so long.
We'd have to get you one of those microphones, you know, like they have them in Zumba classes.
Yeah, like Tony Robbins would wear. Like, hey, America, we're going to learn how to paint again with Tony Robbins. Or that dude from that Infowars.com, that guy, Alex Smith, or whatever his name is. I don't know.
Alex
That's
Jones.
A friggin' nutcase.
Alex Jones.
Yeah, he's a nut. Somebody tag him in this. You're a nutcase, bro. Infowars.com, you're friggin' nuts. Headline.
You know what would be even cooler? Is if we put you in a Deadpool outfit.
Oh my god, if I had one, I would wear it all day. I'd wear it to work. I mean, what are we talking about here? Say it like it's a punishment. I'd be like, ooh, yeah.
I mean, we do have one, it's not big enough, it's Bailey's.
Oh, please, yeah. Maybe I'd fit my arm down the leg sleeve. There we go, little teeny tiny details, imperfections.
Hey babe, what if Ryan Reynolds was painting this painting right now?
Then he would be like, hi guys, go over and join Boost Mobile, T-Mobile Internet. And we shot this with a $5 camera or whatever. I don't watch a lot of his commercials. It's wrong, I don't pay attention to the commercials. Here we go. It's funny, every time I get put on the spot, I can't do an impersonation of him. Here we go. My favorite one's from that movie Waiting, where he's like, it's just a whisper, though. Okay, let's do a couple more highlights over here, just to say we got a little bit of brightness.
Oils with mix says Steve Ross does it 20 to 30 people.
Yeah.
Josh is normally topic of conversation.
Yeah, true. Go to a Steve Ross class. I'm talked about a lot over there. The guy that paints with Steve Ross, his name's Bram. He knows me. We're friends. People go take Steve's class and talk about me.
And
which is,
wear a paint with Josh.
Yeah, they literally go to Steve Ross's class in this shirt. And I love Steve. If I could freaking have the opportunity to paint with Steve Ross.
He just never comes to the West Coast.
Right? Come to this side, man. Everybody stays over in Florida and stuff. Hey, there's artists over here on the West Side, all right?
Better
come hang out with us.
Better Butternut says, can you do his Deadpool voice?
I get put on the spot and I can't even remember a line from Deadpool. So, somebody give me a line. Line? Somebody give me a line. Okay, that looks very cool. Very Christmassy, very wintry, very excellent. I love it. I'm going to toot my own horn, but it's pretty excellent.
What about bad Deadpool, good Deadpool?
What do you mean?
It's a line from the movie.
I just say bad Deadpool, good Deadpool? Uh-huh. Oh, that's it. No, there you go.
Say the magic words, Fat Gandalf.
Fat Gandalf.
Yeah. All right. You're supposed to say the beginning bit, too.
Oh, say the magic words, Fat Gandalf. I don't know. I'm trying to focus. I can't be Ryan Reynolds right now. All right. Come up here. Remember, anytime we're going softly over the sky, don't touch anything. Don't touch the tree. Don't touch anything. Don't touch the star. Don't touch the mountain. You got nothing. Very cool. Very cool. I hate that the glare is right there, but that's okay. All right. Let's see. Very, very softly. I don't want to have so much texture in here, but all that texture is room for little details. Little things that you couldn't even have painted if you tried. And then all of a sudden, they just drop themselves onto the canvas like that, and you have this really cool thing. Come down here, soften this guy. Don't need all that thick texture right here. This guy is very thick. You just kept adding and adding and adding to him, right?
Say maximum effort.
Maximum effort.
I know what we're doing this afternoon.
New mission unlocked. Are we watching Deadpool?
Yep. He got Ajax from the dish soap.
I like, he got Ajax from the dish soap. I like the guy that's in the movies with him, like that nerdy guy. I love that nerdy guy's voice.
Yeah.
He's got the best voice. Just taking a little of these trees, because I just realized they were just kind of floating. We never took the bottom of them and pulled them out. So you take them, pull them out a little bit, a couple little things, here and there, there and here, and all of a sudden we got little dips in our snow, little hills, little stuff happening. Very cool. Very cool. Very cool. cool.
Cheryl says needs Christmas lights.
On which one?
On all of the trees.
On all of them. Let's try one with Christmas lights. All right, let's go in. We need to make up a few different colors. So we'll drop a little bit of liquid white onto our red. Drop a little bit of liquid white onto our pile of yellow. Go back again. Did that just, no good. Into our green section. And into the blue section. Which is going to be hard to get to because it's all mixed up and nasty with the black and the crimson and all that. Now we're going to wash off that little brush. Little liner brush. I'm going to start to mix them up. So we'll go into the white and the red, just like this. Just get up a little bit, mix it in. Littlest bit. Maybe this guy on the end, he had some lights. Pop in a little red, little red. Remember, you're going to have a lot of different colors, so you don't need a whole lot of lights. Come back into the yellow. Mix that guy up with the white, just so it'll stick. Pop in a little yellow light. Here, there. Everywhere, right? Wipe off the brush. You don't want to contaminate the colors. Come back to our little green section. And you don't have to put a whole lot of lights because we already have highlights on there. You know what I mean? Come back. Maybe a little green one there. Green, green, green. Don't all have to be the same, right? But now we got a couple little lights on them. Go back into our blue. Really mix it up, but it remains kind of thin because of that liquid white. And then we got our blue guy over here, over there. And maybe one on the top. Man, don't need a whole lot, but very cool little soft little Christmassy scene. Couple little colors, couple little lights. Very neat. All right. Let's see, what can we do? We have to add in our birds. So let's take a little bit of the white, mix it in with that blue section again. So we can have some blue birds. Blue moon.
Sandra
twist.
Says,
so it's very
Sandra
thin.
Says Christmas lights on the tree on the right.
The tree on the right? Alright, let's see. Come in here. These birds represent myself, my wife London, and our gorgeous little daughter, who's gonna be mad if she's not very bright. There we go. Excellent. They go into every painting that we do at Paint with Josh as part of the signature. And it's the only way we get to travel together. Like when vacation comes around, it's normally either my wife and daughter go somewhere or my daughter and I go somewhere. And one of us has to stay at home and watch the animals and do all that stuff. We'll pop in a couple little bits of blue into the dark bits of this tree. This guy's a little bit bigger, so we can add more, right?
Guys, let's try and get to 100,000 likes on TikTok.
Come on, guys. Tap that screen. Tap, tap, tap.
We're almost at 90,000.
Come on. We could do that. 90,000. Mix all that green up so it's nice and sloppy. Come in. Just load up the tip of the brush. Go back in. Pop a few little green bits in. Wipe
Denise,
off the brush. Clean
Denise
it.
Says, I painted 6 years with Bob Ross.
That's awesome.
Hold on. No, hold on. There's comments coming. But there is something in your paintings that makes a spark when painting. I love Bob, but you make paintings come to life.
Oh, thanks so much. I very much appreciate that.
Jesse Bear says, love your videos. Thank you for sharing your skills with us.
Thank you, mere mortals.
All the best to your family and you.
Well, they do call me Poseidon, God of the Ocean. So, Lord of Waves. Master of Tides.
The patron saint
of waves. The patron saint of waves and tides and all sorts. Okay, we're going to mix in the last little bit of the red into here. Pop in a few little red bits. And this
guys,
is why you got to leave space in between. You don't want them all to be at the same spot.
Guys, we hit over 90,000.
90,000, guys, come on.
Just 9,100. Three likes to go.
Just 9
Jesse,
billion to go.
Thank you for those 99 stars sent on Facebook. Really appreciate it.
You are amazing. Thank you. Watch, we'll pop in a couple over here, too.
Jacobs, user 361700, says, your work is magical. If you are interested in purchasing this artwork, it will be available on Etsy within about an hour after the live.
Yep.
I was just looking, babe, and I was like, wow, we've been live for 2.5 hours. And then I was like, oh, no, we haven't. We didn't start till 11.
Oh, yeah. That, we normally start at 10. That would be a lot. Watch, I'm going to put a couple little green bits and different parts of these guys.
That's super cute, babe.
Just a couple, though. All right, because we're going to come back with all these other colors. Come back with all these other colors. So let's get our blue lights. Not the only color we don't have on here. On some of these guys. And just come back, scoop up the paint with the liner brush just so it's on the tip. Come in, drop a couple. You don't need to be everywhere. Don't want them to be everywhere.
Come on, guys, we're at 93,000. Let's see if we can get to 100,000 for this light.
Come on, guys, we're trying to break an old record. There we go, get that red. Maybe sneak a little bit of the crimson over here with the red. There we go. Just so it's nice and sloppy, and it will come off of our brush when we touch things. Kind of aiming for those dark areas, right? Cool little bit of Christmas lights, all sorts of stuff happening. Very neat. It's very neat. Bam.
Can we do it? The birds are in. The only thing we're waiting on now is a signature.
Come on, guys. We're trying to get to 100,000 taps on the screen. We can do it.
5,800 left to go. Let's go, guys.
5,800 tappy tap tappers. Dude, we could throw a big old tree in the
No
front
big
there.
Old tree. No, babe,
like
it's
a
beautiful.
Stick.
Stop. No.
Like a tree trunk.
Babe, stop. It's beautiful. Stop.
Oh, what about over here? Just
no,
a small
stop.
Guy. Just a little stick.
It's beautiful. Please stop.
Just a little stick coming
babe,
out.
Babe.
Sticky.
Babe, I will snap your paintbrush in half. Stop.
She's going to break it, guys. Help me. Someone
stop
help.
It. No one's going to help you.
Tap, tap, tap on the screen. Hey, if we get to 100,000 likes, I'm going to add in a... If we don't get to 100,000 taps, I'm going to add in a freaking tree.
Please tap, guys. Please tap.
I'm
gonna
do
no
it.
Giant stick trees.
By the time that
Please.
I get done cleaning these brushes...
Nope.
If we don't hit 5,000 taps...
Oh, my goodness, guys. Tap that screen. Otherwise, he's just going to whack this giant
oh,
tree in the
be
middle
like
of
as,
it.
It's going to be as big and thick as this brush all
no,
the way through.
No, say no to the oh. giant sticky tree, guys.
Holy
please,
moly.
Please hit that screen. Please
no,
hit
come
that
on, guys.
Screen.
Let's do a big, giant, big giant
Bailey,
tree.
Bailey needs to be brighter. She's very difficult to be seen.
Okay. We can brighten her up.
Come on,
oh,
guys.
You're just trying to take
Come
the
on,
time away.
Come on, we're
going to
distract him, guys, from yeah. painting his brushes so he doesn't,
just trying to take
he doesn't
time
stick
away.
That giant tree in the middle of the painting. Come on, we got less than 4,000 to go. Come on, guys. We can do it. With 40 of us in TikTok, we can do it.
Now she's super bright.
Beautiful. Come on, guys. 2,800, 2,700 likes to go. Let's go. Tap that screen. You can use both fingers. Get both both those taps in.
Uh-oh.
Come on. Come on. No giant trees.
It's coming.
Tap the screen. Tap the screen.
The giant trees is coming.
I think this is what I'm going to do from now on. Just the lives. So I'm going to set a total. And we're going to reach that total. And you're going to be quiet through the whole life.
All right. I wonder how many taps we're at now.
Guys, come on. Come on. We're down to the very few. We only need a few more. We don't need many more.
Let's see where we're at.
Come on, guys. Almost home stretch. Babe, you haven't signed your painting, so you need to sign your painting.
I know.
Come on, guys. We're running out of time.
It's coming down to it.
We're running out of time, guys.
Tick, tock, tick, tock.
Guys, we're running out of time.
Okay, let's do this.
Yes, we did it. No tree. Yes. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much.
I wanted to put
so
a
much.
Giant tree in
Thank
there.
Thank you so much, guys.
Oh, man. Well, another
you
time.
You guys are amazing. Thank you so much.
Another time.
No, no, no.
All right, I'll put a little teeny
no,
tree
no,
in there.
No, no, no. I'm going to hit you.
Look, he looks like a JK. Ouch! It's the signature. It's not a tree.
JK, just kidding.
Just kidding about the big tree. Okay, guys. All right, well, we want to thank everybody for tuning in, for watching, for hanging out with us, for doing all sorts of stuff. I always find these little bristles in the in the painting.
Again, if you guys are interested in purchasing this painting, it will be available in about an hour after the live ends.
Yeah, well, about half hour. I'm gonna immediately put it on the wall. We're gonna take a picture, and then we're gonna go post it. So yes.
I got it. I already know what you're saying.
We are live every Saturday and Wednesday. Thank you so much, Deanie. I understand your fingers are cramped. Mine are doing the same thing. If you are interested in buying this painting, you can head over to paintwithjosh.etsy.com. If you like what you saw today, drop Josh a follow. Tap that screen. Send those gifts if you can. Share and comment. We go live every Wednesday and Saturday in December. Can we stay for the bloopers? We're being asked on TikTok.
That's funny. Yeah, when we do, I'll start including TikTok into. Well, that's the thing. Like, I don't want to show you guys all the tutorials live when I want you to go watch it on Wednesday, right?
Well, yeah, we'll disconnect. Maybe I'll just do Facebook and YouTube, and just TikTok can stay.
Oh yeah, but I want the TikTok people to go over to YouTube when the video comes out.
Well, yeah, that's true. So maybe no for TikTok.
Yeah. But every so often, I'll show you on TikTok how we're going to do a certain thing, or if it's something that I need to practice, that's when I'll go live on TikTok and practice something I need. So
yeah, keep an eye. You know. Hit that notification bell so that you know when Josh goes live and you get notified.
Hit my noties.
Fuzzbear says, your work is awesome.
Oh, thanks, Fuzzy. Fuzzy is awesome. You should see him crochet.
That was slightly creepy, babe.
It's all creepy at Paint with Josh, so.
He just wants fine. The flex.
Oh. Nobody wants to see that. All right, we're going to scrape this up real quick. We'll say goodbye to everybody. We've got another live show on Wednesday. Tomorrow is the day we normally do a Seascape show, but in December, I think it was Christmas Day is on a Sunday, and I didn't want to mess around and do it. No one's going to be watching on Christmas Day anyway, so. I can't wait until Wednesday. The next time we see you guys, go over to my event on TikTok and register for the event. It's free. It'll just tell you the, you'll get a notification when it starts to, when the show starts. It'll notify you that we're live if you register for the event. And again, it's free. Same thing on Facebook. Tomorrow I'll be posting the event for Wednesday. So go find the event on my page tomorrow and register, by clicking going. And then on YouTube, you guys already know, we'll be putting out a post over on YouTube telling everybody when it'll be, and you guys already know when it'll be. You're on my Facebook, you're on my TikTok, you're on my YouTube. You're everywhere. You're Paint with Josh, you're everywhere.
And if you want to see cool content, you can always head over to Facebook. Schedules are posted there as well as on the YouTube
London makes all the wicked graphics and stuff and memes and different things that we post. Our schedules, our Friday funny jokes, the, fan appreciation stuff that she does. She makes these excellent things. So, without her, the page would just be a bunch of, pictures of the same paintings and stuff. Which she tells me. So.
Monday motivation, funny Friday. What do you do with leftover paint? If you have any questions, guys, drop those questions
drop them in
right now.
So, with this leftover paint, it will probably be still wet enough to where I can use at least a little bit of it for the show on Wednesday. If not, then I scrape it off and throw it out. So, I've heard you can freeze it or like saran wrap it and do all this other stuff. But I'm literally painting so much that I'll save all of this and do it. I need to do another tutorial for Tuesday. So I'll paint that with the paint that I have left over. It never just goes all to waste, unless it's like just the smallest amount, you know what I mean? Like this much amount of the red, I would not be upset at throwing that out. It's not gonna bother me. So. But the red, we only use really for sunsets and like little flowery highlights and
different
stuff.
You can freeze it. If you put paint in a freezer.
I'm gonna go put the it's a deep freezer.
Just for your palette.
It doesn't have to be very deep, maybe like 3 inches deep. Cool little mini deep freezer. About as big as this palette, and then I'll be able to stick it in there. My problem would be I would leave it in the freezer too long and then forget, and then I would have frozen paint when I'm trying to set up for the show.
You pull it out 5 minutes before. Where's the palette?
Oh, man. So, well, again, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. We never want to hang out for too long. Got to leave you wanting more, right? So,
I can't wait to see your versions of this painting. I can't wait for you guys to go over to TikTok and let's see. Bam. Why don't we just back this up just a little bit?
Okay.
Can't wait for you guys to go over to TikTok. From TikTok over to YouTube and check out all the other content that we have over there, right? It's not just lives on TikTok and then they disappear. We have them on YouTube. We have them on Facebook. We have them on other platforms where you can go rewatch them and learn how to paint. And it's going to be fantastic. So, until we see you guys again next time, I want to thank you for tuning in. I want to thank you for hanging out. I want to thank you for being awesome. And thank you for all the gifts. And we love you. And until we see you guys again next time, say goodbye, London.
Bye.
Come on, screen.
No.
Come on.
No.
Come on.
No.
London is hilarious.
No.
Put your hood up like this and just so you can see the profile.
In order for me to come on screen,
yes, like
I have
that.
To come super close.
Okay, just like that.
No.
Yeah, come on.
No.
So,
no, I'm not doing
go
it.
Go check out London is Hilarious on TikTok. Follow her. She's my wife. We need to get her to the exact same amount of followers as I have.
That's not going
to
happen.
But she's really funny. Go over and check her out. We love you guys. We can't wait to see you back on Wednesday. Check the live on my TikTok. Check for the live on Facebook. And we'll see you back here
on
the next one.
Drink your water. Be kind. Take your medications. Get some sleep.
Don't be a butt. Yeah. Right? And don't touch the moon. Never. No, I'm just kidding.
Bye-bye.
So, until we see you guys again next time, take care. Have the rest of a good day. I'll get him out of here, babe. We're done for the day. Radio voice comes out when the show gets over.